It's locked. My interruption.
Do not apologize, my son. Father Tobias Whitaker is always happy to teach mortals about the inn.
I am Dr. Jonathan Reed.
A scientist?
Do you know Nurse Dorothy Crane from the Pembroke Hospital? I'd like to know more about her.
I don't like the liberal ideas of nurses. But I especially abhor that Nurse Crane you mentioned.
Why do you hate Nurse Crane more than...
Before coming to London, she was a member of the
So you're not exactly...
Nuns should be...
I have had enough for tonight. Goodbye.
Excuse me, sir. Are you familiar...
Sorry.
Dr. Reed...
I heard you're investigating.
Not much, I'm afraid.
I'm afraid one of the nurses.
Ah, could.
Without a doubt, you.
I don't know much about the man. He's very cautious. Never goes out. Doesn't seem to have any friends or family.
He never goes out?
No. A few days ago, he unexpectedly did. I followed him. But it was just a ruse to keep me away from his house.
Really? How do you know?
He went to the nearest mailbox, but just before posting his letter, he ripped it up and threw it.
He has no relatives at all?
No. Except for...
Where can I find this mister?
He spends most of his time lurking around...
Goodbye, Mr. Darby. Farewell.
No.
Your father is worried about you, boy. He asked me to look for you.
So my father actually worries about me then.
So, may I ask you a few questions?
I'm not bothered. What could be worse?
Do you know Nurse Dorothy Crane from the Pembroke Hospital? I'd like to know more about her.
Yes, I know her. She came here to examine me when I was very sick. She said I should go out more.
Goodbye, young man. Take care of yourself.
Even my dreams are soaked with gloom.
I can't believe I'm doing this. I have this thirst for blood. I can't believe I'm doing this. Good evening, miss.
Good evening, sir.
Actually...
Then you...
Oh.
Ah.
Goodbye, Miss Swanborough. Perhaps we'll talk...
way!
The content of Darius' letter to his children could give me more leverage to enter. Darius is a bit less of a mystery now. It should not be that.
Mr. Petrescu, just 1 minute, please.
You again. Go away.
Sir, wait. Stop this nonsense. I know Nurse Crane is here. Shall we speak man to man, you and I?
All right. Speak up.
Don't you see we're on the same side? We fight to help the poor.
I'm nothing like you.
Yes, you are.
I have to admit it. If you want to talk,
we've not been.
I am.
So Dorothy's real name,
like my.
She seems in.
More.
Tell me.
I do not.
Who is she?
She's not.
You say she has.
Well.
Are you not?
She is.
Are you in
love? Don't be.
Tell me
I do not.
So Dorothy,
like my,
she seems
more.
Goodbye, Mr. Petrescu.
Yes?
Goodbye, Mr. Petrescu.
What do we have here, nurse?
Patient Razvan Vasily. High fever running on 3 days. Complaints of dizziness, muscle aches, and head pain. Diagnosed with influenza.
Treatment?
Aspirin and salicin for the fever and discomfort. Liquids for dehydration, but he's having trouble keeping even water down.
Aspirin and salicin, you say? Why not some warm milk and a kiss on the cheek? Where are the quinine salts?
Tried buying, borrowing, even stealing. There's none to be found, Doctor.
He's not convulsing. He's choking. He's not getting any air. Scalpel! Hand me that scalpel!
What can I do, Doctor?
I need to perform a tracheostomy. Short pipe. That rubber tube will do. We're going to cut a passage for air through the neck.
Yes, Doctor. He's breathing again, but he's coughing up blood.
Internal hemorrhaging. I need to make another incision into the chest cavity to drain the fluids from the lung. Prepare another tube.
A thoracostomy? Doctor, we've nothing to fight the infection. We need an aseptic environment.
Right then, Nurse Crane. What do you suggest we do?
I've no idea. I'm not the doctor.
Time is of the essence. We need to perform a thoracic drain.
Yes, Doctor. He's still bleeding, Doctor. I'm losing his pulse.
The drain must have punctured the intercostal artery. There's too much blood.
Are you all right, Doctor?
I can't see. Yes. Yes. I have this, nurse. Allow me to finish the procedure alone. I need the room.
I'd prefer to stay and see this through. This is my patient, Doctor. I have needle and thread for stitching the wound.
Good. The stitches are holding. How's he doing?
We're losing him. We've lost his pulse. He's dying, Doctor!
dose of epinephrine, now.
Yes, Doctor. We've lost the pulse. He's gone, Doctor.
Nurse, we did everything we could.
Truly? Everything you could? Is that how you'll report this in your log? Is this how the war went? Piling up one poor corpse beside the next?
This was not an influenza-induced seizure. I've never seen symptoms like these on the continent.
Neither have I. But the previous symptoms leading up to this attack were the same, indistinguishable from the epidemic.
No. There was something more vile in these reactions, something primitive.
There have been numerous reports of mental breakdowns caused by the fever that accompanies the flu itself, Doctor.
Yes, but I'd best take some samples of the blood for analysis.
I doubt you're here to test my bedside manners. I suspect it was more than intuition alone that led you to us. So, how might I be of service, Dr. Reed?
I've come to put an end to this insufferable blackmailing, Dorothy.
Doctor, you think your warnings scare me? I've stolen and plied, blackmailed and lied, but what else am I to do? I'm all these people have.
You've convinced me of the sincerity of your actions and their noble justifications. But all the same, blackmail is a crime, and it will stop, Nurse Crane.
So, are you going to turn me over to the authorities?
Nurse Crane, there is no question that the work you've done here is extraordinary, but this dispensary is incapable of coping with the outbreak. It's only a question of days before the situation at hand will overwhelm us. I cannot allow it. It's my duty to put an end to this immediately.
I'm not ashamed. I did what was right. For in the end, I saved lives and you took them. But we had so much in common, Doctor. Don't you see that?
Hello, Mr. Petrescu.
Hello, Dr. Reed. Yes? Assist Dorothea helping our comrades now that I...